History is black history. There is no difference between non-color and color. Having a darker shade of skin doesn't mean you can't reach the same expectations as others. Black is creative, black is beautiful, black is unique, black is American. Now we will have a musical selection by Makaya Crosby, Makaya Heavens, and Amaya Smith. Applause. Coming up, we'll have Drumline performing.
performed by BJHS students, directed by Mr. Temple. Now we will have the Brown versus Board of Education skit.
Good afternoon, Brooklyn Junior High School. At this time, we will now present to you the Brown versus the Board of Education U.S. Supreme Court case. The setting is in 1953 in Washington, D.C. The Supreme Court must decide if it is fair to segregate public schools.
All rise. The U.S. Supreme Court is now in session. Please be seated.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Now calling the case of Oliver Brown versus the Board of Education of Topeka, Kansas. Are both sides ready?
Ready for the position, Your Honor.
Ready for the defense, Your Honor.
We will begin by hearing both sides make opening statements. Then we will move on to our own questioning. Finally, we will hand down a decision. Please begin with opening statements.
May it please the court and the council, the law is quite simple in this case. The 14th Amendment to the Constitution was adopted on July 9, 1968 as a part of the Reconstruction Amendments. Amongst other things, the amendment clearly states in the Equal Protection Clause that individuals in similar situations be treated equally by the law. Amongst other petitioners in this case, Oliver Brown lived in an integrated neighborhood and chose to send his daughter to the school closest to his residence. When he tried to enroll his daughter at this school, the same one all of her neighborhood friends attended, he was denied enrollment and referred to the local segregated school. This is in direct conflict with the 14th Amendment, as the segregated school. She is clearly in similar circumstances as her friends and should be allowed to enroll at their school.
The school district may now give an opening statement.
Thank you, Your Honor. May it please the court and the council, I agree that the law is simple in this case. The discrepancy does not exist. The Supreme Court has previously allowed segregation through the Plessy versus Ferguson case under the separate but equal clause. Therefore, the school was well within its rights to refuse students to attend their school of choice, as equal schools exist for both races.
Could the petitioning party please clarify a few things for me? Are you arguing that the condition between the two schools create a disadvantage for the students attending the segregated school?
Yes, the petitioning party believes that sending students to the segregated school will hinder their education.
Do you have any evidence that testifies to that fact? Are teachers less qualified, the curriculum less rigorous, or the school not funded as well?
While the petitioning party does not have statistics and facts on every area of curriculum and teacher, Your Honor, we do have evidence in all those areas, which was submitted to the original petition to the court. No, Your Honor, once again, we are arguing that it's not just the location of a school, but also the quality of a school and a child's potential once she is told she must go to an alternative school. In the case of Lynn Brown, she must now walk 6 blocks to reach a bus, which will take her to the alternative school over a mile away. If she was going to the school of her choosing, she could walk 7 blocks to the actual school. No, Your Honor, once again, the petitioning party is arguing that the child's potential is lower once she was told to accept, once she's told school. And you are good enough to be held at the same academic standards, but not good enough to go to school with everyone else.
Thank you. That's all we have for the petitioning party at this time. We would now like to hear from the primary petitioning party, Mr. Brown. Mr. Brown, please tell the court why it is so important that your daughter attend this particular school in this particular school district.
I have been pushing this issue, and I am standing here today because I believe that my daughter should be able to attend the same school as the girls in her neighborhood. She has lots of friends with us. I am standing here today because I believe that my daughter should be able to attend the same school as the girls in her neighborhood. We live in a nice neighborhood in a nice area of town where she has lots of friends her own age. She just is similar to the girls in her neighborhood. She even goes to a similar church that her neighborhood friends attend, and she is equal to every aspect of her life except this one.
Is it important to you only because that's where her friends are going?
No, Your Honor. It is important to me because every day I send my daughter to a different school, I am telling her that she is not good enough to attend the same school as her neighborhood friends.
Have you considered moving to another school district, one that is more accommodating of your situation?
No, Your Honor, the way I understand it was public education was established for the government to serve the people. It is not serving the people when the people have to move in order to receive it fairly.
Thank you. That is all we have for you at this moment. Now we would like to question the defending attorney. What evidence does the school district have to refute the petitioner's claim that the schools are equal?
The school district has submitted data on each school and has found that they are comparable. The school board feels that it would be impossible for any two schools to be identical. The school district feels that it would be impossible for any two schools to be identical.
What
What is the school district's response to the district court statement that segregation has a detrimental effect on students who are sent to alternative schools?
The school district does not feel that this is a real problem and that students can overcome this issue in the same way that students who are rejected from their first choice for college must go to their...
Thank you. That is all we have for the defending attorney at this time. Would the chairman of the school board please step forward? In your own word, what is the main reason the school district objects to allowing the students go to the school of their choice?
The fact of the matter is, this is not just a school board decision. It is not limited within the school district. It is Kansas State law, and we provide separate but equal schools.
Does the school board truly believe that students can receive an equal education when separated?
Yes, Your Honor, we do. If we did not, then we would not be contesting the situation.
Does the school board have any evidence to contradict the theory that segregation has a detrimental effect on a student's education due to the emotional effects on separation?
No, we do not. But I have not seen any solid evidence to support the claim either.
Thank you. That is all we have for you at this moment. We will now...
The Supreme Court was unable to come to a decision in the first hearing in 1953 and asked to rehear the case later that same year. It wasn't until 1954 the Supreme Court signed unanimously against the school board. They said that it was unconstitutional and violated the 14th Amendment. They then began the process to desegregation in the United States, making it possible for all U.S. citizens to get fair education no matter what race. All because Mr. Brown had a dream.
Today and tomorrow, I still have a dream. It is a dream deeply rooted in the American dream. I have a dream that one day this nation will rise up and live out the true meaning of its creed. We hold these truths to be self-evident that all men are created equal. I have a dream that one day on the red hills of Georgia, the sons of former slaves and the sons of former slave owners will be able to sit down together at the table of brotherhood.
Dream that all of our students will go on to college and become successful and productive members of society.
Hi, I have a dream that our Brookwood Junior High School students will be more motivated to participate in science and STEM activities.
I have a dream that one day there will be another black president.
I have a dream that one day I'm going to go to college and play professional basketball.
I have a dream that one day everybody in the world will be treated equally and fair.
I have a dream one day that I'll become a doctor and be successful in
life. I have a dream that all kids at school will be nice and have fun.
I have a dream that everyone will treat themselves with love and respect.
I have a dream that there will be world peace.
Dream that our young people will make a fantastic difference.
I have a dream that everybody be nice to each other. I have a dream that people can get along.
I have a dream that people should care about each other more.
I have a dream that everybody should be safe. I have a dream that everybody should be kind. I have a dream that everybody should be treated equally.
Hi, I'm Miss Luca. My dream is that all my eighth grade students either meet their expectations or exceed at their IER testing, and that you all graduate.
I have a dream that there will be no more shootings.
I have a dream that they will stop violence.
I have a dream that police stop shooting innocent black people.
I have a dream that black people stop killing each other.
I have a dream that all the gun violence will stop.
I have a dream that I want kids to stop hurting themselves.
Hey guys, my name is Armani Cologne, and I have a dream that everyone wants to be treated equally.
I have a dream that when I get older, I'm gonna work at DCFS and take care of the homeless.
I have a dream there'll be no negativity.
I have a dream that there'll be no discrimination and gun violence.
I have a dream that the world won't be so discriminated as it is now.
I have a dream that everybody will be caring.
I have a dream that people will stop fighting and get along.
I have a dream that everyone will be respectful.
I have a dream there will be no abuse.
Yo tengo un sueño que nosotros podemos vivir juntos con paz y prosperidad.
I have a dream one day racism will stop.
I have a dream that everything can be fair.
I have a dream that people don't have to fight and use weapons to have pride.
I have a dream that Brookwood students will find the help they need.
I have a dream that everybody will be nice to each other.
I have a dream that every child will enjoy freedom.
I have a dream that our country gets better.
I have a dream that everybody will be successful.
Dream that our students will take care of us as they take over this country for us.
I have a dream that everybody stops fighting.
I have a dream that I'll be a president and I can make this world a better place.
I have a dream one day that there'll be less violence in the world.
I have a dream that my four little children will one day live in a nation where they will not be judged by the color of their skin, but by the content of their character.
I have a dream that the violence is going to stop.
I have a dream that our future students will not have to worry about gun violence in schools.
I have a dream that one day everyone will be respectful.
I have a dream that one day I'll be wealthy enough to help my family.
I have a dream that all students are kind and compassionate towards one another.
I have a dream that gun violence will stop.
I have a dream that everybody could be friends.
I have a dream that without violence, the world will be a better place.
Hey, I have a dream. This is Mr. Smith. I have a dream that all of you realize your true potential. You guys are special and you can do it. Thank you.
I have a dream that we should stop gun violence.
I have a dream for equal pay to everyone.
I have a dream that there will be no more wars.
And that all kids will grow up and be successful.
I have a dream that every student will think before they act so that they can be the best version of themselves now and for the future.
I have a dream that guns should be put down.
A dream that people can be happy where they are in life.
And that air pollution will be gone.
I have a dream that the black community will be more accepting.
That everyone will have equal rights.
I have a dream that one day our kids will not have to worry about bullying in school.
I have a dream that all students will love school.
I have a dream that police brutality won't be as big as a problem as it is today.
I have a dream that school will be cheaper.
I have a dream that the school education system becomes better.
I have a dream that the 5% nation and the Nation of Islam will finally get the recognition that they deserve.
I have a dream that our students will find success in their careers in the future.
I have a dream that the world will finally be at peace.
I have a dream for equal rights to end racism.
I have a dream that there will be equal rights for everyone everywhere.
have a dream that more resources are given to the homeless.
I have a dream that the homeless will get a home.
I have a dream that everyone will stay true to themselves and not worry about what others think about them.
I have a dream that world hunger ends and everyone is equal.
I have a dream that people enjoy life.
I have a dream that everyone becomes successful in life.
I have a dream that gun violence will stop.
I have a dream for equality.
This is Swerves, and I have a dream that all my students are as successful as can be.
I have a dream that there won't be any more animal cruelty.
I have a dream for health and happiness for my family.
Dream that we can reduce our carbon footprint and improve the health of our planet for generations to come.
I have a dream that bullying will stop.
I have a dream that we should put the guns down and stop the violence.
I have a dream one day that everybody could be helpful to each other.
I have a dream that the world will become a better place.
I have a dream that one day, down in Alabama, with its vicious racists, with its governor having his lips dripping with the words of interposition and nullification, one day right there in Alabama, little black boys and black girls will be able to join hands with little white boys and white girls as sisters and brothers. I have a dream today.
I have a dream people will be comfortable being themselves.
I have a dream that more girls will enter the STEAM field.
I have a dream that the world will be better.
I have a dream that one day that gun violence will stop killing children.
That our students will feel more comfortable and confident with their mathematics and will take on the challenge in the future.
I have a dream that we can stop all gun violence.
I have a dream that in the future I will be successful.
I have a dream that the world will stop violence.
I have a dream that one day I'll grow up to be a famous singer and not have to worry about fighting.
I have a dream that students have self-confidence, that they really trust themselves, and they have the perseverance to really go for their dreams and achieve it.
I have a dream that expressing yourself is normal in a future society.
I have a dream that cultural appropriation won't be as big as a problem in the future as it is today.
I have a dream that one day every valley shall be exalted, and every hill and mountain shall be made low, the rough places will be made plain, and the crooked places will be made straight, and the glory of the Lord shall be revealed, and all flesh shall see it together. This is our hope. This is the faith that I go back to the South with. With this faith, we will be able to hew out of the mountain of despair a stone of hope. With this faith, we will be able to transform the jangling discords of our nation into a beautiful symphony of brotherhood. With this faith, we will be able to work together, to pray together, to struggle together, to go to jail together, to stand up for freedom together, knowing that we will be free once. And when we allow freedom ring, when we let it ring from every village and every hamlet, from every state and every city, we will be able to speed up that day when all of God's children, black men and white men, Jews and Gentiles, Protestants and Catholics, will be able to join hands and sing in the words of the old Negro spiritual, free at last, free at last. Thank God Almighty, we are free at last.
Black is beautiful. Black is beautiful. Black is fleek. Can't nobody have black beak. Black is powerful. From slavery to black bravery. From a 44th president. From plantations to pop culture sensations. Couldn't talk in public. Now we speak without any hesitation. It has always been beautiful, no matter the generation. My black is resilient, even without reparation. My black is beauty, my black is strength. That's why this February, I celebrate my melanin.
Hello, I'm Emily Riker, and my poem is called Peace.
falls like a veil. Freedom calls like a bird. Sunlight falls to the tree. They all come in a herd. Finally, black people are free. MLK fought for blacks. There were protests everywhere. All were peaceful, there were even cuts, though most of this wasn't even fair. But here we are today, blacks stand with us, and peace is here to stay.
I'm just an icon living. I can't live. I'm not a mind, I'm a menace. That's why you come out like a professor. At the time to put you in a stretcher. I'm here and I'm still flexing. But what you call an icon then? Got a regular label, this bitch, let's get it. Whoa, I'm high style, pump 5 minutes. Whoa, we are so high in the business.
Game, we set for peace, unity, and love. Let's go.